7 minutes past the hour. Welcome back to the most news in the morning. Top stories just 3 minutes away. First, though, an AM original, something you'll see only on American Morning. Who needs the food police when there's a food GPS to help you cut through what's good for you and what's not?
It's a new rating system. It's called Nuvol. It ranks foods at a number scale to determine just how healthy they are. Poppy Harlow talked to the man behind it. She joins us now, and the surface just sounds very simple.
It does sound simple, but big food companies don't love it. You know, 64% of Americans say they're making changes to their diet, trying to eat more healthily. And you'll notice on junk food even, it says whole grain or reduced fat or low sodium. So food companies are pushing to make it seem like their food is healthier. But this new system is trying to, as you said, Karen, break through the fat. They say, look, you have to go a lot deeper than just what the front of the package says. Take a look.
Almost everything in the produce aisle, almost everything, will be above 90, between 90 and 100, because it's higher fat. The reduced fat version is considerably higher in sodium. It's also higher in sugar.
Let's grab raisin
bran. Raisin bran's pretty good, yeah.
This is what I ate growing up.
Sure, so. Okay.
26.
Yeah.
That's what this gets. No, wait, look at this. This Neapolitan ice cream. Dr. Katz says the real value isn't to compare ice cream to cereal, but to see how similar products stack up against one another.
Okay. So let's find Cheerios and Fruit Loops.
None of the major food companies we contacted would go on camera to discuss Nuvol. Junk food is big business for these big American food companies.
Right.
If the Nuvol system is adopted, it's billions in revenue for these companies.
But it,
and you know, about 70,000 items have been graded so far in about 750 grocery stores across the country. It is growing quickly, and this, John and Karen, could be a huge threat to a $26 billion a year snack industry in this country.
I'm still trying to get my head around how Neapolitan ice cream has the same nutritional value as fruit.
I know. That was our question. And you know what? The doctor spent a long time in that freezer looking at the ice cream. He said, even I invented this system. I'm not sure why this is the rating. And that's why you hear the critics that say, because you can add fiber, you can add all of these nutrients to anything, but if the basis of it isn't healthy, clean food, then the critics say this system doesn't work. So it could really shake up an industry, but you've got a lot of people that don't agree with it at all.
So what are some foods that are 100?
100, blueberries, a lot of antioxidants, romaine lettuce. Iceberg lettuce is only an 82, and yet most of us eat iceberg lettuce. So anything that are clean, clean, bright fruits and vegetables, that's going to get you 100, but pretty much nothing else.
Well, if the guy that invented the system is confused, what's a consumer to do?
That's
right?
The question. That's the question. But it does guide you sort of in a better direction, yeah. I will say that.
Poppy Harlow, great story this morning. Thanks.
You got it.
Well, we're crossing the half hour right now. Time for a look at our top stories this morning. Worse than the tsunami and the